on a commuter train in the freezing rain sat another average Joe. He looked at tropical scenes and travel magazines, knew he probably never would go. And Joe had a vision, he made a decision to go down where the water's still blue. If he was gonna survive, he'd have to learn how to dive, and that's exactly what he set out to do. So he got off at his train stop, walked into a dive shop, and showed the girl the picture he'd seen, where they got steel drums a-playing and palm trees a-swaying. She said, "I know just what you mean. I'm gonna teach you to dive, I'll get you certified, then I'll take you down someplace where it's warm. Then you can star on Survivor as a certified diver, but first you'll have to fill out this form." Now his friends all call him Scuba Joe. He knows the stuff that only divers know. He spends all his time down below. There's nowhere that he'd rather be. He's always hanging with his diving friends. That's where the scuba party never ends. As long as no one ever gets the bends while they live life. Joe was successful, but his job was so stressful, vacation was long overdue. But with the scuba lessons and some therapy sessions, it looks like he might pull through. Just an average Joe who was sick of the snow, now he's a lifetime member of Dan. He can't wait to be seeing the blue Caribbean. At least this boy has got him a plan. Friends, I'll call him Scuba Joe. He knows the stuff that